Oh my goodness, that thing is screaming.
Hey everybody, I'm back. It's Ben with Fishing Inside the Lines, and instead of our normal crappie trip, fishing trips that we're doing on the videos, this is something different. I'm down at the coast staying at Port Bolivar for a couple of days with my brother, and we're going to be fishing for redfish, some trout. If the weather's good, we'll head offshore and see what we can find in state waters along some of these wrecks or platforms. Maybe we can find some snapper or something else. We'll see, but I think it's going to be a great trip. Trying to get this channel to grow, and so if you like and what you're seeing on this video, hit that like, subscribe, I would appreciate it. We need your help in order for it to grow. But I think this is going to be a great trip. It's obviously hot. It's late summer here in Texas, but it's going to be great fishing. Stick around. See you on the water.
He's moving.
Okay, yeah, that's gonna be a while.
I'm afraid he's gonna break that leader again.
Enjoy the fight. I'm gonna get mine out.
Yeah, probably, just in case. He's coming up. Let's see if I can keep that leader. Oh my goodness, that thing is screaming. I can't tighten it up anymore without it breaking.
Just let it fight for a while, because
I think it just let go. No, he's there. He's still there. He swam up, I guess. Wow, that's a big fish.
Might be the biggest fish you've ever caught.
Trying to protect that leader. Because how many have we broke already?
Take your time. Keep pressure on it.
Wow.
I need time to boat or real time?
You're okay right now. Can't do anything with this guy yet.
Give me some ground. And you know, when he turns, he's like, no, never mind.
I have a lot to make up right now. Yeah. This is a heavy, heavy fish. Don't know what it is yet. Have not seen anything. And he is, wow. Oh, wow. I'm sweating over here. We're not even close yet, Chris.
That's okay. I'm not in a hurry.
Be a big old stingray.
It's possible. I did think about that.
This is a great, I mean, heavy, heavy fish. Might be a stingray, but I don't know.
10 foot diameter stingray.
Halibut. We got halibuts in Texas. Set those up there, please.
Halibut would be awesome.
If we don't land him, I just want to see what it is.
Yeah, boat.
I like this knee pad. My guess is it could be stingray. I don't know. You don't break your rod.
I didn't worry about that rod. You've got drag on there. You shouldn't break the rod, but I'll give you any slack.
Got a little bit.
You gotta be getting tired. This may be a 30-minute job here. Now just the top, he's gonna make another turn.
Just hoping this battery doesn't. I'm hoping this battery doesn't run out because I was yellow already. So start that other one, will you? He's coming to the surface, or he's running out. Yeah, just hit the top button. Turn it around this way on the suction cup if he's going around the boat. Can you watch this other rod here?
Yeah. He hasn't done too much
here. Oh, there he is. At the top. Look at him.
Yep.
Is that a red?
Oh, that's that big old thing that you've been looking at.
All right, get the net. We're getting that sucker.
That's the thing that's been swimming around forever. So.
Yep.
I don't have to undo this.
I'm still good right now. Come on. I'm still good. I just checked. Still yellow. It's not red yet. All right. Bringing him over. Get him that first time. Oh, that was big.
Oh, that's big enough.
It'll work.
Just sturgeon.
There he is. In the head. Hang on.
Couldn't reach him.
Oh man. Yeah. Oh my goodness.
He's going all the way back.
Oh my goodness. He's going back down to 50 feet. Yes, he is. He's coming up easier. This is going to be it right here. This is going to be it. Heads this to the left. Let me turn him. All right. You got him. Oh, my goodness. Who get?
I'm telling you, he ain't going to fit in this net.
Half of his body will, his heavy body will.
He may slap me in the head and knock me out with
your tail. Well, good thing I got GoPro going. All right, here we go. He's still coming up. I can get him up now. So he's tiring.
He didn't like the way that
net. You just got to do your job. Hold the bottom of the net so it's not in the water. Hold it flat. Yep, just like that. And let it go right when you get to his head. That way he won't see it as much.
Yeah.
There he is. That dude's big.
I need a gaff.
He's tiring out because that was not as big of a run there. Get ready. Oh, wow.
I'm ready.
Oh, he's that one's on.
He wasn't even in the water. Something came, he's hopping.
Who's?
What am I gonna do with this thing?
Just get his head in, head and body.
He ain't there yet.
I think it's Cobia. Get him.
He's not there. He's 10 feet under the water.
See his fin? That's Cobia.
The weight wasn't even on the top of the water.
Get tired.
You're tired. You gotta get him up to the top, though.
There's the weight. This sweatband's not working too well. I'm getting sweat in my eyes. Okay. We both had a breather here. We'll get a loop his tail then.
Loop his tail with a rope.
Yep.
You're gonna have to fight him longer than that. So we need a gaff. You don't have a lot of fight left.
Just hoping this line didn't ricochet and hit you in the head with a weight.
I'm worried about too. Obviously, we're not keeping this.
No. I just want a picture of it.
Yeah. You gotta finish the job there, young man.
Somebody should have a bigger net. Here it comes.
I do have a tape measure, too, by the way.
You do?
Yeah.
You would you rather be on this other side?
No.
Okay.
I mean, might be easier because it's shaded, but.
No, no, I'm at where I'm at, and I switch with you.
No, I don't think it matters. I was waiting for him to get up to the top enough to.
If I didn't know if on my side you could scoop over to get his head like that versus him trying to come into you more. Got him. That'll fit in the net. Woo!
Oh, he's out. He's out.
Oh, Chris.
Oh, no. Dude, he was in.
He was all the way in. What is wrong with you? I need a different net, man.
I couldn't lift him.
There he is. Let me see. He was all the way in the net. Folks,
yeah, you want to catch him?
That was
again?
A big fight. I am wore out. 48 inch cobia. Time for a nap. 48 inch cobia. I'm wore out. We're heading back in.
Good day, though.
Great day. Fishing in the Sportsman Masters 227. It'll handle it. See you next time. Hey everyone, at the end of the show we'd like to do a short devotional, and so the verses that I'm going to read to you today are Matthew 6, 9 through 13. So this is the Lord's Prayer, and it's, Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil, for thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. The verse of that I want to focus on today is where it says, give us this day our daily bread. You know, this is referencing back when the Israelites had escaped Egypt and they were wandering in the forest, and God provided manna from heaven. So bread from heaven, each day he gave them their daily bread. And so it was teaching them, trying to teach them to rely upon God and to trust him for your needs every single day. So not to just rely on our own dependence, but put your trust and your faith in him. So something I came across as I was looking at this, I also found in John 6, verse 51, it says, I am the living bread. This is Jesus talking. It says, I am the living bread that came down from heaven. If anyone eats of this bread, he will live forever. And the bread that I will give for the life of the world is my flesh. So that there is referencing when Christ was crucified. He knew that he was going to be crucified and die on the cross. And so he was giving his body, his flesh, for us, for the world, so that we may trust in him and that we may live forever. Once we do die, that we may once live forever in heaven with him and the Father God. And then something else that I came across, I didn't write this, but I thought this is pretty fitting. It says, this petition of the Lord's Prayer then teaches us to come to God in a spirit of humble dependence, asking him to provide what we need and to sustain us day to day. So again, not to rely on our own understanding of the world, or, you know, a lot of times I do it a lot too, that I got this, I can do it, right? We want to rely on our own dependence, which in some things is okay, but important decisions, we should be going to God in prayer, seeking God, seeking his wisdom, asking him what his will is. And so that's our daily bread, right? Not just food, but important decisions in life. So what is it that's your daily bread that you need? So whatever that is, I ask that you pray to God and that you ask him to provide that daily bread, that need for you each and every single day. You know, we're supposed to be in prayer with God constantly, not just when things are going wrong, but constant prayer. So
That is my prayer. You speak with God. If you don't know Jesus as your Savior, I ask, my prayer is that you would trust in Him, that you would accept Him to be your Savior, and just rely upon them instead of being so dependent on ourselves all the time. So that's it. Thank you, guys. What is it that's your bread? What is it that you need? All right. Stay safe. God bless.